Is there science to support the notion that you can be healthy at any size?
There's quite a lot of science supporting the idea of health at any size. I think that when I talk about the science, one of the like common pushbacks is, how dare you say that obese people are healthy? Let's look at some numbers, shall we? This data is from a 2008 study of 5,400 study participants that evaluated cardiometabolic health, looking at, and I'll read this out so I have it exactly, blood pressure, serum triglycerides, fasting plasma glucose, C-reactive protein, the HOMA index, which is a measurement of insulin resistance, and LDL cholesterol. And so if two or more of those measurements were out of the normal range, they were considered metabolically abnormal. And if zero or maybe one of them was outside of the normal range, but everything else was normal, they were considered metabolically healthy. What this study showed was that among overweight individuals, 51.3% of them, so more than half, were metabolically healthy. Among obese individuals, almost a third, 31.7% of them were metabolically healthy. And among normal weight individuals, nearly a quarter, 23.5% of them, were metabolically abnormal. It's statistics that unequivocally show that our assumption that a larger body is unhealthy and a smaller body is healthy is wrong. And what is a problem here is not just the assumption that drives healthism and fat phobia, weight discrimination for the overweight and obese people. But look, there's like nearly a quarter of normal weight people with risk factors for type 2 diabetes and cardiovascular disease that are going unrecognized, that they are also missing out on really important healthcare because of the assumption that just because they're thin, they must be healthy. So it really is a problem on both sides. What studies show is that how active you are, the quality of your diet, how much sleep you get, how much stress you're under, your resilience activities, your social determinants of health are the inputs into your cardiometabolic health, and that your weight is a very poor proxy for measuring health, that most of the time it's irrelevant. It might be a symptom of an underlying health condition that needs to be treated, right? Hypothyroidism, for example. It might be an indicator that there's some diet and lifestyle changes that need to happen, but it also just might be a thing that also coexists with a really healthy diet and lifestyle. Or it might be something that we're completely missing in normal weight individuals because of that assumption. So we need to like just stop with the healthism and fat phobia.